a new show. NXT TakeOver. London, England,
and the action continues
in the
this week
NXT,
NXT
geography location says Orlando, Florida. Of course, I already know that. I still don't know everybody's name on NXT. God villains.
Look at these two.
Yeah. I like it. A little Sherlock Holmes tribute.
This is ridiculous. Why anyone would leave their house in such ridiculous attire is beyond me.
When in London, Braves.
Oh, so they're pandering? So
it's like
okay
Sherlock Holmes.
It's okay to dress like a complete fool when you're pandering.
Have you seen your outfit lately?
I'm the best dressed guy in the company, Saxton.
So apparently, Aiden English is Sherlock Holmes and Simon Gotch. Am I right?
I believe you're accurate, Rich.
Okay, let's make sure I was on the money.
I like that.
It'll happen to have you along this week. Rich Fetter alongside Byron Saxton. And they
put your hands together. Corey
Graves here in London. Still can't get over what a great event we had last week. And wow, what a main event. It was Samoa Joe and Finn Balor for the NXT
title. We expected an epic battle for the championship, and that's exactly what we got. What a night it was. But then again, tonight, let's top it all. Why not?
Kicking things off with a fatal four-way tag team matchup. And after the event of the tag team title match last week between Dash and Dawson and Enzo and Cash, you got to think that one of the teams in this matchup, a victory could put them one step closer to a title opportunity and a chance to take down Dawson.
Yeah, it's very compelling to see who's going to be able to step up. Keeps getting better.
The hype rose.
Teams are all in some some sort of costume so far. You got Blake and Murphy's doing the Freddy Krueger thing. You got the Bond villains doing Sherlock Holmes. And the Hype Brothers dressed as complete idiots.
I think Alexa looks like a Christmas one.
Yeah, I wonder what that order reminds me of.
Alexa Bliss reminds me of Trish Stratus.
You're like two varsity football players with their high-maintenance cheerleader.
You say that like it's a bad thing, Saxon.
It is
a bad thing. You got beat up by the football team most of your high school life.
It only happened once.
Talking about Christmas trees and Christmas presents, what a gift we have tonight, the return of Sami Zayn.
Oh, man.
So, NXT is coming back.
Justin Jordan and Gable.
Coming to the ring at a combined weight of 466 pounds, Jason Jordan and Chad.
NXT Tag Team Champions and the Boss Villains and Blake and Murphy. You got the Hype Bros who are always a threat. And then you have Jordan and Gable who the last couple of months here in NXT have lit the Tag Team Division on fire.
Yeah, you're talking about making an impact in short order. Gable and Jordan have absolutely set the world on fire over the last few months, and they are showing no signs of slowing down.
Yeah, two men who came to NXT with exceptional accomplishments. Jason Jordan, two-time NCAA Division I qualifier. Chad Gable competed in the 2012
Summer Olympics, hype crowd.
Olympics, which were held right here in London.
You can always expect something unique from the crowd and the audiences in the UK. Japan, I know they're like more concentrated in Canada, and then certain cities in the U.S. It's always got rowdy crowds.
Tag in your own partner in order to preserve your life in this matchup.
Obviously, the first team to gain a pinfall or submission will be named the winner. Well, at least theoretically, become one step closer to a possible tag team title opportunity.
Dash and Dawson obviously always looking for new number one contenders.
You know, here's the thing. All these teams are paying such close attention to that match last week between Enzo and Dash and Dawson to see who is going to come out on top. And more importantly, who do you not prepare yourself for down the road if you do get that title opportunity? Chad Gable, just fun to watch.
Incredible offense to Chad Gable. Simon Gotch, who has quite the unique offense of his own, seems not quite sure what to do with Gable.
You're not going to out-wrestle Chad Gable. The guy's one of the best on the planet.
Seven national championships as a Greco-Roman wrestler.
Mojo Rawley tagged himself in.
The crowd gets something for every, almost every NXT person.
Gosh, right on the back of the
superstar. Jeez.
Guys, he ain't hyped.
He ain't hyped.
Thank you for sharing that with us.
No problem.
Tag made to Zack Ryder. Look at that teamwork by the Hype Bros. Missile drop kick. And Ryder for the win. And to break it up comes in English.
Yeah, keep up with all this. His body's flying everywhere.
It's about to go down right here in London.
This is an incredibly physical, demanding business.
Freaking
it's not
commercials.
A job, it's a lifestyle. Injury.
I really don't know what I have in store, but I'm not getting my hopes up.
I was thinking that they would have had a network. The television network years ago,
plus WWE
before they came out with the NXT, they messed it up.
Yeah.
Oh, it's still going.
WWE Breaking Ground tonight, immediately following NXT only on WWE.
Gotta see that.
This fatal four-way tag team matchup continues. Right now, Aiden Anderson, Zack Ryder, the two legal men. Again, this type of a matchup, anybody can tag it. Oh, anybody. I mean, Blackjack there. Cover Ryder.
Blackjack. I'm going to see if I can call these moves, that I, if I can recognize these moves.
Incredible reaction once again for Chad Gable.
This guy's one tall dude.
The United Kingdom tour of, yeah.
Say, yeah, they can hear about the reaction tonight, really, all throughout the NXT UK tour.
One of
the favorite tag teams amongst the NXT universe here in the UK. Understandable why. Moves like that.
You can't deny that.
That's a arm drag.
Jordan have it in spades.
Wow. Beautiful drop kick by Chad Gable.
It's been a long time since I've seen that.
Now Murphy tagged in.
Yeah, in case you're wondering how it feels, Murphy.
Hold on, look out.
Look out to who?
Alexa Bliss.
Would you quit talking about Bliss? Gable. She's not doing anything wrong.
Yeah, yeah, but watch Blake. Oh. Hey, yeah, Alexa's not doing anything wrong.
Jeez.
It's all part of the calculated plan.
It's not her fault that the referee was caught up in her good looks.
All three of them were in on it.
Let's take another look. Cover and a quick kick out there. This is what we're talking about.
Yeah, watch. Alexa's got the official distracted here on the left side of the screen. Walking Blade.
The referee was
really
saying Blake and Murphy took advantage of the situation. Maybe we can get this right.
Job being alerting.
Great spin artist. Well, in the meantime, that opens up the door for Blake and Murphy to get the advantage of this matchup. This is very reminiscent of when these two were tag team champions, utilizing Alexa Bliss to cut a corner, to bend the rule.
Yeah, let's just ignore the fact.
I know years ago when during the Attitude Era, that's the big code word now. Not code word, but buzzword. During the late 90s, it was like Raw. Those 2 hours is, you know, pretty good. Watching Raw years ago, I always, like, that was on my mind. Whatever happened on Raw, it was on my mind almost all week. These days, I have no clue what they're doing on these shows anymore.
Obviously, the Vaude villains want
to
get
I have to, if it wasn't for these podcasts like Solid Monster
well.
Or Sounds
as
Off,
much as riding on this match,
Don Tony and Kevin Castle, let's see, Wrestling Suit, Bite That, if it weren't for those podcasts, I would not have a clue what's going on the show. Vince Russo, kind of, you know, because just hearing, you know, it's kind of interesting. I know a lot of people don't like Vince Russo, but hearing his perspective, still, even though, like, I know, like,
you gotta give credit to Buddy Murphy for having the wherewithal to stop.
Some people don't agree with his record after he left WWF.
Good, there's one for Mojo. I never get tired of watching him get punched in the face.
He does bring up some good points, but even though he does, it's a whole different era, and WWE is still in a transitional period where they are trying to figure out their own identity and figure out their own target audience. Oh! Let me see. He's got all the suplexes on there.
Oh! Jason Jordan is single-handedly controlling this match.
If you count on this guy, if you miss, what's that, a T-bone? No, T-bone suplex? No. But he did a T-bone suplex, the second one. Jeez.
Simon Gotch.
There it is. Suplex City. We're laughing like Seth Rollins. And it's better when the camera don't show what he's jumping at. It helps to get it, you know. Cause sometimes these camera people, they be showing the wrong angles, and they miss a lot of. Oh my goodness. Going for the setup. They got it.
What a win for Jordan and Gable. If it wasn't nailed down, Jason Jordan was suplexing it.
These two men are studs. What Jason Jordan here, literally on his own, changed the entire complexion of this matchup. Jordan was on fire.
200 miles an hour across the ring makes the tag. If this is just elementary, my dear Watson, how about that for your little reference?
I like that.
Jordan Gable get the victory in this fatal four-way tag team matchup.
No, that's not it. I was about to say perfect plex, but it's not even a fish hook.
This past week at NXT TakeOver London, Asuka finally got her chance to meet Emma in the ring, along with Dana Brooke at ringside.
Asuka.
One of the most fierce competitors in the NXT locker room, and Emma beat.
I'll be getting her song stuck in my head.
As Asuka's kick to Emma sealed the deal for the undefeated NXT star to walk out of Wembley Arena victorious. We cut off with Emma and Dana backstage after the match.